Good morning, teachers and students. I'm Gabby DeArmas.
And I'm Sophia Brito. Today's March 1st, and you're watching
MAS News.
During the months of March, April, and May, every week, if you buy school breakfast every day, you'll have a chance to win a $25 Amazon gift card. Remember, school breakfast is free for all students. And now to Gabriel Garcia with MAS Music.
Music contains many components that can help people relieve stress. I'm Gabriel Garcia, and this is MAS Music.
For many adolescents, music relieves tension and can be a distraction from other problems going on in their lives. Certain kinds of music are designed to help soothe stress. Music works so well to relieve stress and anxiety that have you noticed when you go to the dentist, there's usually calm music playing in case you're nervous. Several studies have demonstrated that there is a connection between music and emotions. It is also true that the age of the listener and the experiences they have relate to the music they listen to. Most teens use music to rebel against their parents in a way that they won't get in trouble. Teens do this to develop their own identity and to start to become their own person.
That's it for this week's episode of MAS Music. I'm Gerald Garcia, signing off.
Now to Sophia B. with Undercover MAS, reporting about Jeffrey Dahmer's new movie.
With the recent release of My Friend Dahmer, people have started to regain a sudden interest in Jeffrey Dahmer and his story. I'm Sophia Brito, and this week on Undercover MAS, we're looking into the dark past of one of the most infamous serial killers to ever live.
Jeffrey Dahmer, also known as Milwaukee Cannonball, was responsible for the dismemberment of 17 young boys and men, of whom he also cooked and consumed pieces of after he killed them. All his crimes took place between 1978 and 1991. Eventually, police captured Dahmer when a victim overpowered him. He was later sentenced to 15 terms of life imprisonment in 1992. 2 years later, he was beaten to death by a fellow prisoner. 24 years after Dahmer's death, a movie was made about his life before he became a serial killer.
From moviegoers' perspectives, it seems that things are being sugar-coated and nothing is really explained explicitly. So it seems as if they're kind of glossing over some of those more gory or macabre details, if you will.
My Friend Dahmer is a movie about the high school years of a vicious serial killer, Jeffrey Dahmer. Young Jeffrey is played by Ross Lynch. The movie tackles all the struggles that Dahmer went through as a teenager, including bullying, depression, and constant hostility from his parents arguing at home. The film has received many mixed reviews from the public. For example, a reviewer claims that this movie seeks not to excuse Dahmer, but rather to illuminate his sociopathy.
My Friend Dahmer has changed the way that many people look at the notorious cannibal, but others believe that due to his actions, he should not even be considered a human. I'm Sophia Brito, and thank you for watching this week's episode of Undercover MAS.
Now it's Kathy Gomez with Through the Lens, reporting about A Wrinkle in Time.
March 9th is not only the release day of A Wrinkle in Time, but it's also a day to remember the author which inspired the novel, Madeleine Engel. She was an outstanding woman who published many award-winning books, including the famous A Wrinkle in Time. Hey guys, I'm Kathy Gomez, commemorating the brilliant works of Miss Engel.
Born on November 29th, 1918, in New York City, author Madeleine Engel is best known for such novels as A Wrinkle in Time, 1962, and A Swiftly Tilting Planet, 1978. Today, Engel lives on throughout her work. Engel's children were the first audience to A Wrinkle in Time. She read them the story as she gradually worked on it. Her and her family were quite close. On February 6, her grandchildren recognized her adventurous life in the biography they wrote Tilted, Becoming Madeline. Her journey writing and publishing was quite rough, and without a great deal of persistence, the novel would have never been read by more than her children. After 26 rejections, Engel was finally able to find a publisher willing to portray the innovative tale. The novel, however, was not without controversy. Over the years, it has been one of the most banned books because some believe that it is anti-Christian or that it promotes occultism. A Wrinkle in Time's success inspired Engel to write several sequels, creating what is known as the Time Quintet. Engel launched his related series of books, which feature the descendants of Meg Murray and Calvin O'Keefe. There is no doubt that she has left a world of impact within her books. Her best-known novel, A Wrinkle in Time, has now been transformed by Disney into a major motion picture directed by Ava DuVernay. A Wrinkle in Time follows the adventures of 12-year-old Meg Murray as she travels through time and space to find her missing scientist father, Chris Pine.
He has been missing for 5 years, ever since he discovered a new planet and used the concept known as a Terrasect to travel there. She's accompanied on this journey by her brother Charles Wallens and her friend Kevin O'Keefe, which is made possible by the assistance of three unusual beings known as Mrs. What's It, Mrs. Who, and Mrs. Which. Together, the children must brave a dangerous journey to a planet that possesses all of the evil in the universe. Other actors in the movie are Chris Pine, who plays the father, Dr. Alex Murray, Zach Galifianakis, who plays as Happy Medium, Gugu Mbatha-Raw as Dr. Kate Murray, Michael Peña playing as Red, and many more talented actors.
Will it find Meg's father, or will it be led to something else? Get your tickets and be sure to see A Wrinkle in Time in theaters near you on March 9th. I'm Kathy Gomez, signing out for Through the Lens.
Auditorium to one of New York's most prestigious and famous theaters. Throughout the following days, MAS's very own 8th grade vocal students will be taking center stage at Carnegie Hall. I'm Maya Lopez, and this week on Inside Scoop, we're bringing you backstage for their first performance.
Having been open since April 1891, Carnegie Hall has opened its doors to a variety of different talent groups, including several orchestras and bands, as well as showing movies such as August Rush in one of the three structures of the theater. The vocal magnet has included select students from 8th grade onto this high school field trip. The students will be performing for the National Choral Festival under composer Andre Thomas.
Performing in Carnegie Hall is a great opportunity, not just for me, but for everyone else in the choir. Performing with them, it's wonderful because they're so talented and it's such a positive environment to be in.
Practicing and performing for different events for weeks at a time, the vocal magnet is moving their way up to be heard by different talents or experts singing either here at MAS or different public areas. They're expected to bring much publicity to our home school, as well as starting their careers as future artists.
This experience in Carnegie Hall, I mean, it's gonna change your lives. And just that performance of having a great program in a great performing center, you know, in a great location, so historic. I mean, everybody has performed in Carnegie Hall.
Starting from such a large event at this stage in your life, greater things are expected to happen to these future artists. I'm Maya Lopez, signing off for Inside Scoop.
For MAS News, I'm Gabby Diarmas.
And I'm Sophia Brito, signing off.